Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Rodney, and I'm back, and I wanted to talk about love and marriage, Huntsville. Now, this episode was cute or whatever, you know. I was okay with it. So, Maurice and Kimmy. I guess are they opening up a restaurant or something? I don't know what Marceau and Kimmy are doing. Not Marceau and Kimmy, Maurice and Kimmy. I think they're opening up a restaurant, and I guess they're going through, I guess they're trying to determine who's going to be the head chef, I guess. So anyways, nonetheless, they're having a brunch. That's what we're going to talk. That's what we're going to leave it at. They're having a brunch, and they've invited people to the brunch to taste the food. I was about to say messy. Messy Mel. Mel was on one this episode. So they're talking, and everybody has made it to the brunch. Not everybody. Destiny didn't come. Sunny and Moses, they didn't, they were not in attendance. But pretty much everybody else is there. Oh, except for Martell wasn't there. Good. They might as well go ahead and get Martell off the show. Okay. Martell wasn't there either. So outside of them, everybody else was there. So everybody's sitting around, and Maurice says, basically, he asked Letitia, like, is she okay? Because the last time Letitia was on one. And she was getting the party started with Stormy and Nell. And so she was like, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. She was like, it's all about communication, putting it out on the table, right, Mel, right, Kimmy? And then Mel said, well, speaking of communication, speaking of communication and communicating, what's going on with Black? Since we're communicating, okay? Ain't gonna lie, kind of good. She said she sent her students over. Mel has, Mel does something on the side with houses. And she said she sent her students over to, I guess to support Black. And she says when they got there, she said it was around 9 o'clock. She said they were closed. Girl. So I was like, Mel. So Mel, out of the kindness of her heart, decided to send her students over to Black. Or I guess she recommended Black as a place they could go to for, drinks and food. Or, just having a good time. And when the students got back to her, I'm assuming whatever the next day or the next week or the next meetup, the students told her that girl Black was closed. Okay, or somebody probably texts her, Miss Melody, Black is closed. And so Marceau says something about the city shut them down because something about taxes. I feel the story with Marceau and the city of Huntsville, I don't know. I feel like Marceau is leaving parts of the story out. A part of me believes that Marceau, who thinks that he knows everything, cuts some corners and it came back to bite him in the tail. Also, I remember them talking something about parking. Remember they said something about parking? And I feel like whatever's going on at Black, they probably the parking became a mess. It was probably cars. I don't know where Black is located. For the people who live in Huntsville, let me know. Or if you've ever been to Black, let me know. How is the parking there? Does it become a mess? Is Black in the middle of a neighborhood? And if people come out, do they start to park in the neighborhoods? And it becomes just chaotic. So I don't know. Like, I don't know what's going on with Marceau in that business in the tax. It's something about tax, the furniture or something. I don't know. Anyways, they start to talk about basically who's the blame, who's to blame in the Kimmy, not Kimmy, Sonny and Moses. Kimmy surprisingly says Moses. You know, I thought she would have said Sonny. She says Moses. I feel like both of them have some blame, because both of them do. But I do feel like the biggest culprit is Moses. Moses and Destiny, before I guess they crossed that line, they had a 15-year friendship, right? So that alone, he holds most of it. Now, where Sonny gets some of it is because Sonny, girl, if this girl is your producer, and I think everybody who's worked in reality TV, they know what the producers do in the relationship that you have with your producer. Girl, Sonny, you look trifling too. That's just what it is. And I think based off everyone's reaction, it's like, girl, we tell you our business. And if we're telling you our business, and then on top of that, you're also hanging out with Destiny outside of filming, outside of work, y'all have created this friendship. Girl, y'all were friends. Now, were y'all around here, girl, putting y'all blood together as blood sisters? No. Were y'all exchanging best friends bracelets? No. But girl, even if you want to say that you were building a friendship, that's still enough for me. We've crossed the line of professional to personal. And I don't think Sonny wants to admit that. But Sonny also in the same breath says, you know, I was losing sleep. Why are you losing sleep over somebody who you say, girl, you ain't got no loyalty to? So yeah, I put most of it on Moses, but again, Sonny gets a little tugging too. Marceau decides to bring up that he basically—I don't know who brought it up, but it came up that Marceau basically met with Latricia's husband. You know, she's still legally married at this point in the show. I don't know about today. So he met up with Latricia's, you know, husband. And he basically, you know, it comes out that I guess he, you know, kind of checked him and said, in a nutshell, what you ain't doing, Ken basically stepped up and did. Marceau, girl, that's the thing. Like, you know, I always say Marceau get on my nerves. Marceau is someone who I say is a likable asshole. You know what I'm saying? Marceau is probably one of my favorite ones on the show. I really don't. Well, you know, Kimmy was my girl, but you know, but Marceau is really one of my favorites on the show. I think he gives good TV. He's a mess, girl. He's a misogynistic, he's sexist and all of those things, but girl, you know, I still like Marceau. Marceau be on some shit. Marceau be telling the truth sometimes. Marceau was really low-key clocking Trisha and Ken. So now I'm looking at Ken a little sideways too. Like, girl, quiet as it's kept, y'all were trying to act as if there was no involvement between the two when they first started talking. And maybe the husband was right when he says they were already talking. Because to Marceau's point, yeah, I said, ooh, Marceau just clocked them, girl. To Marceau's point, they said, so basically, Latricia and Ken were trying to give the timeline of when they, you know, I guess got in, not necessarily intimate, but once they started, I guess, talking. And then also the point where they were just like friends in a way. Like, we didn't cross that line until like years down the road. But just like Marceau said, oh, and then Ken was basically saying how they would stop talking. I guess it was like a back and forth with Latricia and her husband. You know how y'all do, girl. We together, we not, we together, we not, we together, we not, whatever, right? So I guess anytime Latricia would be back with the husband or talking to the husband or whatever, child, Ken would kind of step away. And then I guess when things would go left again, Ken would kind of step back into the picture. So to Marceau's point, Marceau said, y'all sitting here basically trying to act like it wasn't that big of a deal and it was nothing going on. And it wasn't no sneaky link type of situation. But girl, why are y'all stopping something that doesn't need to be stopped? I said, oh, that's the truth. Even with Ken being a man and Latricia being a woman, if it was strictly just we're friends at the gym, I ain't talking to that man don't talk to me, it would be nothing to stop. Unless it was something that needed to be stopped. Marceau is right. In my opinion, Marceau is right. Latricia and Ken, it had to have been something there. Even if somebody started liking somebody, even if Ken started liking Latricia first, it still was something there. And you felt like it needed to stop so no one would cross that line. You can't really say that y'all were real friends. Like, in my honest opinion, Martell and Destiny are friends. You see what I'm saying? If Kimmy met up with Martell by herself, no one would think anything. We would think it was just a friendly conversation. I think we've seen Martell and Kimmy go out to dinner. I think it was Kimmy and Marceau. Nobody would think anything. You see what I'm saying? Because there's nothing, girl, it's nothing to hide, there's nothing to stop, because in order to stop something had to start. Girl, Latricia, girl. Ken is given, it is given, the husband could have been right about that part. I just don't think Latricia is being, I don't think Latricia has been honest about most of the shit she done said on this show. And now my good eye is starting to be on Ken too. But Latricia definitely got, Latricia got, girl, both my eyes on her. Not even one. Girl, I'm looking at her just like this. Girl, you know how sometimes you side out of girls? Like, girl, no. I'm looking at Latricia like this. Girl, because, girl, something ain't right. Girl, Miss Melody. Yeah! Miss Melody, come here, sister. Girl, let's have a conversation. Sit right here, sister. Sister, sit right here, Sister Melody. Why your black ass over there trying to defend Ken? Because see, you really just want to just disagree with Marceau and tell them that ain't nothing wrong with talking. It ain't nothing wrong with what was happening. Girl, I want to know if you're going to keep that same energy when you find out that Miss Latricia, who was sitting across from you, possibly was fucking your husband. Okay? I want to know if Melody gonna have that same energy, if the song gonna be different when you find out that girl Latricia was over at Martell's house. Now they say they ain't had no sex, but that's still that the jury is still out on that one, because right now we don't believe Martell or what Latricia got to say. So Miss Melody, why you over there trying to defend Ken and Latricia and them talking, girl, I want you to have that same energy when you find out Latricia was cheesing all up in Martell's face. And Martell was cheesing up in hers. I want you to have that same energy when you find out Latricia and Martell, girl, it was going down in the DMs. So when y'all asses get to St. Thomas, they going to St. Thomas. When y'all asses get to St. Thomas, and girl, you stranded on an island, girl, you can't grab your car keys and go home. I want to see that same energy. Remember, girl, they just talking. Melody was really just trying to disagree with Marceau, not realizing that girl, the egg is about to be on your face in a couple of episodes. That's the real gag. Why Melody should have just sat there the same way you were just sitting there eating your food when they was talking about Sunny. You should have just sat there and ate your food, girl, when Marceau was having a conversation with Latricia and Ken. Because again, girl, the egg is about to be all on your face. Anyways, again, they're going to St. Thomas. Kimmy meets up with Destiny, girl. Ain't nothing, girl. Kimmy and Latricia, not Latricia, Letitia, meet up with Destiny just to tell Destiny that, girl, pretty much they hung out with Sunny. However, she wants to let Destiny know that she is Team Destiny all the way and that she has nothing to worry about. If shit go left, you don't have to worry about me not having your back. You know, this is the thing with Kimmy. And we go, I understand what Kimmy is doing. Kimmy feels like she owes Sunny at least a conversation. Let me just even try to entertain her from time to time because of the fact that Sunny was there for her when she was fighting for her life. So it's not like Kimmy is just like, oh, girl, I'm just going to hang out with the girl. It's like Kimmy has a legit reason to feel like I owe her at least this much. Like, girl, I can at least go to dinner with the girl. I can at least, you know what I'm saying? Like, girl, she was really over here praying for me, checking on me when I was really, really going through, like, girl, something that could have taken my life. So I get it, but I also understand why, with that being said, Kimmy could also say, outside of that, I'm still Team Destiny. And girl, it's still a tad bit trifling. Anyways, and then Mel meets up with Sunny. So Mel made a comment, and she basically was saying that, I don't know if she made the comment out of her inviting Sunny to the trip, because she invited Sunny to St. Thomas. And I don't know if she made the comment out of basically her that saying that's the reason why she invited Sunny on the trip, but she made a comment and basically said that she basically, like, girl, she literally said, fuck girl code. I'm not mad at Melody for saying that. At this point, it ain't no girl code in this group. Because if it really, really was, y'all wouldn't have pulled the stunt in the show that y'all pulled when it was me and Martell going through what we was going through. See, this is the thing Melody is going to have to understand. Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself. Melody is really low-key still pissed off that the group chose Martell over her in a way. They, even after seeing the stuff that we saw from Martell calling Melody a hoe, from him having a girlfriend while married, while him getting her pregnant multiple times, her eventually having a baby, they still run around and call Martell, aka Kimmy, a nice guy. Even with Marceau saying, you know, that's my guy, right? And it is weird, like, girl, you really see this man doing the stuff that he's doing to me. So I get where Melody is coming from. Girl, fuck girl code. Don't miss a shit about no girl code to me, okay? That shit went out the window a long time ago. But also, I believe that they don't too much care for Melody. I definitely don't think Tisha liked Melody. I think at this point, I think that they pretty much pulled Melody and all them to us. When all that shit popped off and the fight broke out in front of Madani, I think that Carlos then pulled them to the side and said, hey, y'all gonna have to get it together. So now I think they're just showing up their co-workers. Even with Kimmy's mother having breast cancer and Melody not finding out until, girl, they were filming. Girl, they don't fool with each other like that. Okay. So Melody's gonna have to understand that they don't fool with her. But I understood what Melody was saying to a certain degree. Like, but I also think you can't be too much mad at you can't be mad at Destiny because of what they decided to do. She feels as though it's real basically messed up that they are now, in a way, defending Destiny, or I guess being Team Destiny when it comes to whatever y'all got going on. But when it was me, they basically chose Martell's side and didn't care. But I also think that this hits closer to home because now with Destiny, the woman who was her friend and producer, I don't know why I'm being friend and producer, she says, what's her face? Sunny says friend. But her friend and producer, like, this lady is right in front of our face. Like, Adriana, whatever her name was, she wasn't in our face. They probably could have, it's a chance they could have had the same energy. Like, girl, y'all really bringing this girl down to the show? But I don't know, because again, they don't too much like Melody. But I get what Melody was saying. Mel feels they didn't have her back like they have Destiny, considering all that. I didn't like when Mel said considering all that Destiny and Martell have done. What has Destiny done to Melody? Ain't nobody gonna ever get me to believe that Destiny was a bad friend. Now, after the friendship was over, Destiny probably said some shit, did some shit. But girl, Destiny was loyal to a fault to Melody. Destiny would have chosen Melody over Martell, hands down. And instead of Melody just being a grown-ass woman and telling Destiny, girl, I love you to pieces, but because you were friends with Martell before you were friends with me, I just don't trust anyone who's still willing to be friends on Martell, because your loyalty is to him and it's not to me. And then I guess in a way she could have made Destiny choose. I mean, it's really fucked up. And Destiny could have said, well, girl, I understand. But I feel like that's really what it was. And Melody was just pulling at straws to end the friendship with Destiny. But when she says stuff like, girl, considering all that they've done, girl, what have they done? We know what Martell has done. What did Destiny do for you and Destiny to fall out? And girl, I know somebody gonna bring up, girl, she was talking about Melody at the reunion. No, she wasn't. If she was talking about Melody at the reunion, Melody could come out and tell us what the fuck she said. What did Destiny and Letitia say in the room, since you heard everything? Just tell us. But you can't tell us because you were so pissed off at everybody at the reunion, because basically they knew that Martell was cheating on you. And all you heard was Letitia and Destiny having a conversation and your name being mentioned, but you don't know what the conversation was about. They could have been in the room saying Melody was the baddest bitch on the stage, but all you heard was Melody. Anyways, but yeah, I get why she is a little pissed off at them, and you know how she can come, how she's, you know, the picture that she's trying to paint, because The two situations are pretty parallel, in my opinion. You do have Sunny, Moses, Destiny, but y'all are Team Destiny, and y'all have let it be known. But then when it was me, girl, and I was married to this nigga and got 4 or 5 kids and all types of shit going on, and y'all walking around here calling him a nice guy. Girl, but you got Kimmy talking about, girl, Moses is the biggest culprit. But then you'll turn around and say that Martell is a nice guy. So I get why Melody is like looking like, but again, Melody gonna have to understand, but they just don't like you. It's a hypocrisy, it is. It's contradiction, it is. It's all of the above. It's some bullshit, it is. It's some fuck shit, it is. Girl, every word you can think of, girl, it is. But it is what it is. But I don't think that the way that she tried to deliver the tea to Sunny, like Kimmy was kind of like, right? I don't think Kimmy's riding the fence. I think Kimmy is, again, showing the way that Melody presented the information to Sunny was like, Kimmy low key, like, girl, you sure? Like, girl, yes. I don't know if Kimmy has told Sunny, but girl, I can meet up with Sunny. She's cool. She all right. But girl, when it comes down to this whole Destiny stuff, girl, I'm Team Destiny. I can show appreciation for what she did for me while I was battling cancer. But girl, I'm still Team Destiny at the end of the day. It's almost like Melody wants you. I feel like Melody is one of those people, you have to be with that person all the way through. And I think that's why it's hard to be Melody's friend, because if you call Melody out on something that you feel is wrong, she could be right on this, but wrong on this. She could be right on that and wrong on that. I mean, right on that and wrong and right on that and wrong on that. But I feel like Melody is the type of person you have to be like 100% all the way in. And I don't think that's how friendships work. Because, bitch, when you wrong, you wrong. When you right, you right. Y'all see how I just said I felt like Melody was right about, I can understand where she's coming from with the how she's drawing the comparison between her situation versus Destiny's situation and how the group is reacting to the situations. I can understand what Melody is saying, but I also think she was wrong when she said, considering all that Destiny and Martell have done to me, what the fuck has Destiny did to you? Anyways, girl, that's it. I'm gone. I'll talk to y'all later. I can't wait to see Melody's reaction when she find out Latricia was over at her husband's house. Was Martell and Melody still legally married at the time? So just remember, girl, they were just talking. Latricia and Martell were just talking. Ain't nothing wrong with talking. Ain't that what you said, Melody, girl? Ain't that what you said, Melody, girl? All right. We're going to see what you got to say. We all over in St. Thomas. And you find out the tea about this woman who you invited to the trip. And she was possibly over there hopping on the dick and doing a full split. Okay. Anyways, I'm gone. Shout out to Latricia. Shout out to Ken. Shout out to Melody. Shout out to Martell. Shout out to Sonny. Shout out to Moses. Shout out to Letitia. Shout out to Marceau. Shout out to Maurice. Shout out to Kimmy. Okay, who else? Shout out to Stormy. Shout out to, what's her husband's name? I forgot her husband's name. Courtney. Okay. Is that everybody? Shout out to Miss Wanda. Yeah, shout out to Miss Wanda. Okay, we want Miss Wanda back on the show. All right, I'm about to give me something to eat. I'll talk to y'all later. Y'all have a good night. Bye, y'all.